वक्रतुण्डमहाकाय सूर्यकोटिसमप्रभा निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देव सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा। सरस्वतिनमस्तुभ्यं वरदे कामरूपिणि विद्यारम्भं करिष्यामि, सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा। गुरवे सर्वलोकानां विषये भवरोगिणां, निधये सर्वविद्यानां दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने, व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं, नमामि भगवत्पादं शङ्करं लोकशङ्करम्। सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम्, अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्। साक्षात्कृतं दयानन्दं परमार्थस्वरूपिणं, तत्त्वज्ञानप्रशास्तारं प्रणतोऽस्मि परं पदम्। ॐ सहना भवतु, सहनौ भुनक्तु, सह वीर्यं करवावहै, तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। ॐ पार्थाय प्रतिबोधितां भगवतां नारायणेन स्वयं व्यासेन ग्रथितां पुराणमुनिना मध्ये महाभारतम्, अद्वैतामृतवर्षिणीं भगवतीं अष्टादशाध्यायिनीम् अम्ब त्वाम् अनुसन्दधामि भगवद्गीते भवद्वेषिणीम्। नमोऽस्तु ते व्यासविशालबुद्धे पुल्लारविन्दाय तपत्रनेत्र, येन त्वया भारततैलपूर्णः प्रज्वालितो ज्ञानमयप्रदीपः। प्रपन्नपारिजाताय स्तोत्रनेत्रैकपाणये, ज्ञानमुद्राय कृष्णाय गीतामृतनुभे नमः। सर्वोपनिषदो गावः दोग्धा गोपालनन्दनः, पार्थो वत्सः सुधीर्भोक्ता दुग्धं गीतामृतं महत्। वसुदेवसुतं देवं कंसचाणूरमर्दनम्, देवकी परमानन्दं कृष्णं वन्दे जगद्गुरुम्। भीष्मद्रोणतटा जयद्रथजला, गान्धारनीलोत्पला शल्यग्राहवती कृपेण वगनी कर्णेन वेलाकुला, अश्वत्थामविकर्णघोरमकरा दुर्योधनावर्तिनी सोत्तीर्णा खलु पाण्डवैरन्नदी कैवर्तकेशवः पाराशर्यवचः सरोजममलम् गीतार्थगन्धोत्कटम् नानाख्यानकेसरम् हरिकथासम्बोधनाबोधितम् लोके सज्जनषट्पदैरहरकः पेपीयमानं मुदा भूयाद्भारतपङ्कजं कलिमलप्रध्वंसिनः श्रेयसे मूकं करोति वाचालं पङ्गुं लङ्घयते गिरिं यत्कृपात्तमहं वन्दे परमानन्दमाधवम् यं ब्रह्मा वरुणेन्द्ररुद्रमरुतः स्तुन्वन्ति दिव्यैस्तवैः वेदैः साङ्गपदक्रमोपनिषदैः गायन्ति यं सामगाः ध्यानावस्थितद्गतेन मनसा पश्यन्ति यं योगिनः यस्यान्तं न विदुःसुरासुरगणाः देवाय तस्मै नमः। नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयमुदीरयेत्। You can repeat after me. Ashochyananvashochastvam.
Ashochyananvashochastvam.
Prajñāvādāṃsca bhāṣase.
Prajñāvādāṃsca bhāṣase.
Gatāsu na gatāsaṃsca. नानशोचन्ति पण्डिताः
नानशोचन्ति पण्डिताः।
ओके, सो वी आर स्टडिङ्ग् दि इन्ट्रोडक्टरि भाष्यं टु दिस् श्लोक। We have not yet studied the Bhashyam to this shloka, but we are saying the introduction to this shloka, introductory Bhashyam to this shloka, because Bhagavad-pada had not written commentary for the first whole chapter and the first 10 shlokas of the second chapter. This Bhashya starts from the 11th shloka of the second chapter, which we are yet to study. That is Bhashyam, the 11th shloka. So in this introductory Bhashyam to the 11th shloka, in this part of the Bhashyam, we were studying that Purva Pakshi, the opponent, he favors his argument. If he favors his argument, what is his argument? Jnana karma samuchaya. He favors his argument by quoting from the Gita. In the last class we saw that. Atra kechit avabhu sarva karma sannyasa purvakat atma jnana nishtat आत्मज्ञान निष्ठा मात्रात एव केवलात कैवल्यम न प्राप्यते एव। किम तर्हि अग्निहोत्रादि श्रौत स्मार्त कर्म संहितात् ज्ञानात् कैवल्य प्राप्ति ही सर्वासु कीटासु निश्चित अर्थ इति. We read this line. And to support his argument that karma sagita jnanat eva mokshaha, he quotes from the Gita. He remains by quoting from the Gita. Jnapakam cha agahu asya artasya, in the meaning of that. That is the jnanam with karma, the combination alone gives moksha. In that meaning, he aptly quotes from the Gita itself. Atachetamim dharmyam sangramam nakarishasi karmanyevadikaraste kuru karma ivatasmatam ityadi. So he quotes from the Gita and wants to establish that the tatparya of the Gita is karma sagita jnana teva mokshaha na kevala jnana mokshaha iti. That is his argument. Our Purva Pakshi partly agrees, but still he is a Purva Pakshi because he doesn't totally disagree and he partly agrees with Siddhanti. We cannot accept his contention. If he partly disagrees, then also he is a Purva Pakshi, then also his tatparya cannot be accepted because we cannot compromise on the truth of the reality. There is no accommodation possible. When it comes to the tatparya, when it comes to the truth, jnana teva mokshaha, no accommodation is possible. It is not that we are fanatic, but this is the truth. There is no fanaticism involved here. The truth is categorical. Jnana teva mokshaha. That is a stand. And karma has its place. Karma has its own place. But that has no role. That has no direct role in giving moksha. That is our contention. Now continuing. And here, he quote from the Gita. I said this, if you don't fight, you will incur papam. Therefore, kuru karma. And you have got choice only with regard to karma, the activities, action. So by quoting appropriately, Purva Pakshi argue, he present the view that jnana karma samuchayat mokshaha, karma sagita jnana mokshaha iti. Then the Purva Pakshi means opponent, our opponent. Then the Purva Pakshi, he imagines that if anyone counters the karma, his argument, counters the karma by saying, if karma is cruel, if karma involves himsa, is it not against the injunctions of the Shastra? This is the imagination of the Purva Pakshi. So Purva Pakshi himself presents the contention of his opponent. What is the contention? If karma involves himsa, is it not against the injunctions of the Shastra? Because Shastra says, himsam na kuriyat, do not hurt any beings. Since Shastram enjoins observance of ahimsa, if karma, whether it is Vaidika or Laukika, if it involves himsa, then how can it help in gaining moksha, as it is against the injunction of the Shastra? So, imagining that to be the contention, Purvapakshi, he himself raises question and gives the samadhanam. Himsadi iptatvat vaidikam karma adharmaya iti adharmaya. Himsadi iptatvat vaidikam karma adharmaya. This is the contention of the Purvapakshi. Which Purvapakshi? Purvapakshi to the Purvapakshi. Purvapakshi to our Purvapakshi. This is the contention. Iti iyam api ashanka na karya. So our Purvapakshi is presents the contention of his Purvapakshi, saying that iti ayam iti iyam api ashanka na karya. Ashanka means doubt. Na karya. Doubt should not be entertained. What is a doubt? Vaidika karma involving himsa leads to papam. Adharmaya, papaya bhavati. Vaidika karma, shrauta karma, papaya bhavati, himsadi yuktatvat. Himsadi yuktatvat is hetau panchami. Because it is endowed with himsa. Himsa is hurting, violence, killing. Killing is involved. So, shrauta karma, vaidika karma, it will give papam. Iti ashanka. Iti ashanka na karya. So, doubt should not be entertained. Like this. Why does he say so? Because there are Vaidika karmas which involves himsa. If it involves himsa, then will it not attract papam? That is a doubt. And the answer is no. Papam papaya na bhavati. Ashanka na karya. Doubt should not be entertained with respect to Vaidika karma involving himsa attracts papam iti. So our Purvapakshi, that is Jnana Karma Samuchaya Vadi, he says such Vaidika karma will not attract papam. How? Katam? He answers. We can read the second line of the third bullet point. Kshatram karma.
Kshatram karma.
Kshatram karma.
Yuddha lakshanam.
Yuddha lakshanam.
Guru bhratra putradi.
Guru bhratra putradi.
Himsa lakshanam.
Himsa lakshanam. Lakshanam.
Atyantam kruramapi.
Atyantam kruramapi.
Svadharma iti krutva.
Svadharma iti krutva.
Na adharmaya.
Na adharmaya.
Tad akarane. Tatasvadharmam kirtim cha hitva papam avapsyasi.
Tatasvadharmam kirtim cha hitva papam avapsyasi.
Iti bhruvata.
Iti bhruvata.
Yavad jivadi shruti choditanam.
Yavad jivadi shruti
choditanam.
Choditanam.
Pashvadi himsa lakshananam.
Pashvadi himsa lakshananam.
Chakarmanam.
Chakarmanam.
Prag evam.
Prag eva.
न अधर्मत्वम् इति सुनिश्चितम् उक्तम् भवति इति क्षात्रं कर्म युद्धलक्षणं गुरुभ्रातृपुत्रादिहिंसालक्षणम् अत्यन्तं क्रूरमपि स्वधर्मः स्वधर्मः इति कृत्वा न अधर्माय न अधर्माय तत् अकरणे च ततस्वधर्मं कीर्तिं च हित्वा पापम् अवाप्स्यसि इति ब्रुवता यावज्जीवादिषु चोदितानां पश्वादि लक्षणानां च कर्मणां प्रागेव न अधर्मत्वमिति सुनिश्चितम् उक्तं भवति इति. So now, Purva Pakshi, he says, that Kshatram Karma Yuddha Lakshanam. He gives a samadhanam. Purva Pakshi gives a samadhanam to the objection raised by his Purva Pakshi. Kshatram Karma Yuddha Lakshanam. Yuddha Lakshanam. కర్మ క్షత్రం దట్ ఈస్ క్షత్రియ ధర్మ ఇస్ యుద్ధ ద కర్మ విచ్ ఇస్ క్యారెక్టరైజ్డ్ యుద్ధ కర్మ యుద్ధ విచ్ ఇస్ క్యారెక్టరైజ్డ్ బై ది ఫైట్ యుద్ధ ఇట్ ఈస్ ది ధర్మ ఆఫ్ ది క్షత్రియ సో యుద్ధ టు ఎస్టాబ్లిష్ ధర్మ ఇస్ ది కర్మ. It is a duty of Kshatriyas. Therefore, Kshatram Karma. Kshatram Karma, the duty of Kshatriya is Yuddha. Yuddha Lakshanam. Karma of Kshatriya is characterized by the Dharma Yuddha. Who says, our Purva Pakshi replies to his Purva Pakshi. That we have to remember. We are just watching. We are just watching the argument. We don't have it. We are not saying anything now. We will say later. Yuddha and all for the sake of establishing dharma, it comes under smartha karma. Smriti vinita karma. Smartha karma. Karma prescribed by Shruti is called Shrautam. Karma prescribed by Smriti is called Smartha. Yuddha, fight involves Himsa. It involves Himsa. Here Arjuna has to fight. Not with the enemies. They are enemies in one way, but they are still Arjuna's relatives. But Bhagavan Krishna says, he wanted Arjuna to fight. Doesn't Bhagavan know that killing is Himsa? And that too is own, Arjuna's own kith and kin. But still he ordered Arjuna to take up the weapon and asked him to face the battle. Because Bhagavan himself had enjoined Arjuna to fight, therefore it cannot be adharma. And therefore, no papam is involved. If Arjuna doesn't fight, then only he will incur papam. Because it is the dereliction of his duty, Kshatriya Dharma. Because Yuddha has become the duty of Arjuna, he will not incur papam. Just a minute, my throat is... blocked. 1 minute. Here it is cold and my throat is blocked. I said, because Bhagavan, he himself commanded Arjuna to fight. Therefore, adharma ayana bhavati. If Arjuna doesn't fight, then only he will incur papam. Because yuddha has become the duty of Arjuna, kshatri dharma, therefore he will not incur papam. And here, guru bhratra putradi himsa lakshanam karma atyanta kruram. Atyanta kruram api. Atyanta kruram. Atyanta is extremely kruram. Cruel. Extremely cruel. What is cruel? Guru bhratra putradi himsa lakshanam yuddham. Yuddha lakshanam karma. Yuddha, which is characterized by causing, which is characterized by himsa to the guru, bhratra, brothers, putra, etc. So guru, bhratra, putra, the himsa, lakshanam, yuddha lakshanam, karma, atyantam, kruram api. Kruram api. Though the war is characterized by the killing of one's guru, brother, son, etc., which are extremely cruel, absolutely cruel, still, api, it is not adharmaya bhavati, papaya bhavati, because it is swadharma. It is swadharmaha iti krutva na adharmaya bhavati. Killing in general is papam, but killing in war by the kshatriyas as part of their duty, dharma, it is not papam. Though the Shastram says killing is papam, here it is an exception. Apavada. Apavada is exception. What is the utsarga? What is the general rule? Himsam nakuryat. Do not hurt any beings. That is the general rule, utsarga. Apavada is svadharmaha iti krutva yuddha lakshan karma papaya na bhavati. That is the apavada exception. So always there will be utsarga and apavada. There is no situation which is categorical. And that too in Vyakranam, you will see in Sanskritam, Sanskrita grammar, you will find utsarga and a lot of apavada. So utsarga apavada. Life also it is like that. Utsarga apavada. General rule and exception. Exceptions are always there. Therefore here, apavada is svadharmaha iti krutva yuddha lakshanam karma papaya na bhavati. That is the apavada. Whereas, when dharma is not followed, tad akarane, pratyavayaha, tad akarane, when it is not followed, akarane, pratyavaya, papa will occur. Pratyavaya, papa will occur. Tat akarnecha pratyavaya papaha. Therefore, tataha, when the dharma is not followed, tataha, swadharmam kirtim chahitva papam avapsyasi. When war is not fought, then you will incur papam. Because giving up your swadharma will invite papam. And also, he says, you will lose your fame, kirti. Swadharmam kirtim hitva papam avapsasi. He quotes from the Gita itself, second chapter, 33rd shloka, which we will see. iti bruvata. So saying, iti, so saying bruvata, who? Bhagavan. Bhagavan says, so saying Bhagavan, yavad jivadi shruti choritanam, pashvadi himsa lakshananam cha karmanam, rageva na adharmaya iti sunishchitam uttam bhavati iti. Karma which is enjoined by the Shruti. Shruti choritanam karma which is enjoined by the Shruti. What karma? Yavad jivadi karma. What is yavad jivadi karma? Agni otradi karma. Agni otradi the karma vaitika karma. Yavad jivet agni otram jibuyat. It's a vidhi, it's a rule. As long as you are alive, do Agnihotra karma. So, karma like Agnihotra, etc., which are enjoined by the Shruti, and the karmas characterized by the killing of Pashu Adi, etc. Pashu means animal. Here, we need not take it as an animal sacrifice. Pashvadi, Himsa Lakshananam, so Karmanam, we need not take it as animal sacrifice. If you have Shraddha in Shastram, you can take it as animal sacrifice also. If you have Shraddha in Shastram, then it means karma involving animal sacrifice also will not give papam if it is enjoined by the Shruti as your dharma. Any karma, any agni karma if you take, there are himsa, killing is involved. Any agni karma if you take, there are himsa. Himsa is involved. No karma without himsa. No walking without hurting any beings. Even our simple karma, like walking or eating, himsa is always there. And in Agni Karma, himsa is unavoidable. For example, when you do some Agni Karma, in the Agni Karma, you offer samit or dhanyam into the Agni as the offering, as the aguti. That offering may contain some life in it. We may not be able to see, and that too in the samit. The samit may have some insects in it. You cannot completely avoid it. Even Bhagavad Pada in his commentary in the 10th chapter, somewhere he says that in the samit which is offered to the Agni, there may be some life. And because of that, we incur some papam which is negligible. So it cannot be avoided. That is the thing. So it is impossible. Does it mean that we should not do karma? Does it mean that Agnivotra karma will give papam? If Agnivotra karma gives papam, then the result of Agnivotra karma is defeated. Therefore, Shastram knows all those things. Shastram, it knows all that. But still, the Shastram says, prageva. It is said before, it's a foregone conclusion of the Shastram, of the Bhagavan, that those karmas na adharmatvam, these karmas, they don't have the status of being adharma. Therefore, no papam iti sunishchitam uktam. It is definitely said. It is definitely said. So with this statement, the view of the Jnana Karma Samuchaya Vadi were presented. So Jnana Karma Samuchaya Vadi, our Purvapakshi, yes, replied to the contention of his Purvapakshi. Now our Siddhanti will walk in. So he will answer, because our Purvapakshi, he says, karma sandigdha gyanat mokraha iti. He was trying to establish his view. And now Siddhanti will answer. That we will read. Tad asat.
Tad asat.
Jnana karma nishta yogo.
Jnana karma
nishta yogo.
Vibhaga vachanat.
Vibhaga vachanat.
Buddhi dvayashrayo.
Buddhi dvayashrayo.
It's a simple, it looks like a simple statement, but it is not a simple statement. It's a Sangraha Vakyam. And this Vakyam will be elaborated by Bhagavan himself. Bhagavan means Bhagavad Pada himself. This Vakyam will be interpreted by him, Bhagavad Pada himself. Now, Siddhanti says, Tad, that is Tat, Asat. Asat means not true. Asat is not true. Tat, Asat. It is not true, sir. Your argument is not true. Why it is not true? Why it is Asat? Jnana karma samuchaya is a means to moksha is not correct. Says Siddhanti. We say, Siddhanti is, we are the Siddhantis. Why it is Asat? Because, I'll translate this line. Jnana karma nishtayoho vibhaga vachanat buddhidvayashrayayoho. 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 Not ashrayayoho. Buddhidvayashrayayoho. Okay. Because of this statement, which distincts the committed lifestyle of the pursuit of jnana and karma by the people having different convictions. This is a translation of the simple, this statement, not simple statement, this is statement. But it is not easy to understand just by translation. We have to look into it further. We have to see. In Gita itself, Bhagavan, he distinctly presents the pursuit of knowledge and the pursuit of actions to different sets of people. Jnana nishta, karma nishta. We will see, it will come in the third chapter itself. Jnana yogena sankhyanam, karma yogena yoginam. Jnana yoga, that is a lifestyle committed to the pursuit of knowledge for gaining jnanam, jnana yoga. And karma yoga is the lifestyle committed to the pursuit of action for gaining jnana yogyata. For gaining jnana yogyata and then jnana. So the two lifestyles, jnana yoga and karma yoga, are prescribed by Bhagavan himself in the Gita. So jnana karma nishta yoga, that word is there in the Sangraha Vakyam. So jnana yoga and karma yoga, jnana nishta and karma nishta. These two nishta means the lifestyle, the committed lifestyle. Both are different lifestyles. In one lifestyle, jnanam is pradhanam. Jnana pradhana nishta is for sannyasi and karma pradhana nishta is for karma yogis, grihastha. Through karma yoga, one has to gain jnana yogyata and then through jnanam he gains moksha. This is the scheme. And for both the lifestyles, whether it is jnananishta or karmanishta, moksha is only through jnana. Only thing is that lifestyles are different. Lifestyles are different, but for both the lifestyles, moksha is only through jnanam. Because Bhagavan has said, Bhagavan has prescribed different lifestyles, it clearly shows that jnana and karma cannot be combined. Jnana, therefore, jnana karma samuchaya is not the content of Gita. It is not the tatparya of Gita. Therefore, buddhi dvaya ashrayogo. Buddhi dvaya ashraya yogo. Buddhi means your understanding, conviction. Buddhi means the understanding, the conviction. So the two lifestyles have their ashraya. Ashraya means the basis. That jnananishta and karmanishta, they have the ashraya, the basis, the two different understandings, convictions. Jnananishta has its basis in the understanding that Atma is akarta, Atma is abhokta. Therefore, his lifestyle is meant for the strong understanding, to make the understanding, this understanding firm and clear, that Atma is akarta, Atma is abhokta. So the samshaya, this, to gain this samshaya rahita jnanam, a particular lifestyle is prescribed. And by continuous shravana manana nididhyasanam, that person gets established in jnanam. This is one particular lifestyle, jnananishta, which is generally prescribed for sannyasis. Whereas in karmanishta, another lifestyle which is characterized by the performance, by the pursuit of actions, which has its basis, ashraya, in the understanding that aham karta, aham bhokta, I am the doer, I am the enjoyer. That understanding that buddhi is there. That karmana chitta shuddhihi upasanaya chitta naishchalyam, we say. For gaining jnana yogyata, karma is required. Why? Because karmana chitta shuddhihi. By karma you get chitta shuddhi. And upasana also has got a role. By upasana, the mind is concentrated. Therefore, karma has its place. People who follow or do Vaidika karma, they are different from this body, mind, sense complex. That is why they do karma to enjoy punya. That is why they do karma to enjoy punya and they avoid some action to avoid papa. And therefore, by doing karma which will serve the purpose of gaining jnana yogyata, by doing such karma they get chitta shuddhi. So chitta shuddhaye karma. Chitta shuddhaye karma natu vastu palabdhaye. So therefore it is clear that people who do karma, Vedika karma, they know that it is prescribed by the Vedas. And by doing the karma, they get karma palam. And karma palam, that is either enjoyed in this loka itself or in the other loka. Because karma palam can be enjoyed in the other loka, what is other loka? Swarga loka. In the Veda Purva, if any karmapala is not mentioned, if karmapala is not mentioned for any karma, the blanket rule is Svargaloka Prapti. To go to Svargaloka, you cannot go with this body mind senses, with the physical body mind senses. Therefore, they know that they are not this body mind sense complex. But at the same time, they know that they will exist after Marana. They will go to Svargaloka and they will enjoy it. Therefore, aham karta, aham bhokta, that understanding, that conviction, that buddhi will be there. Therefore, it is for them, aham karta, aham bhokta. Aham karta, aham bhokta will be there. That buddhi is there. And the Veda itself, another way to establish that jnana and karma, they are different, they cannot be combined, is the Veda itself has got two parts. Veda itself has got two parts. Karmakanda is there, ஞானகாண்டா யூசர். கர்மகாண்டா ஃபார் கர்ம யோகிஸ். கர்மகாண்டா ஃபார் கர்ம யோகிஸ். கர்மகாண்டா ரிக்வயர்ஸ் தி நாலேஜ் தட் அகம் ஜீவாத்மா. அகம் ஜீவாத்மா, தட் இஸ் வை த பர்சன் டஸ் கர்ம அண்ட் யூ வில் என்ஜாய் த கர்மபலா இன் தி ஸ்வர்கலோகா. அண்ட் ஞானகாண்டா விச் இஸ் ஃபார் சாங்கியாஸ், விச் இஸ் ஃபார் ஜானிஸ், ஞானகாண்டா ரிக்வயர்ஸ் தி நாலேஜ் அகம் அகர்த்தா, அகம் அபோக்தா. ஆத்மா இஸ் அகம் ஆத்மா, ஆத்மா இஸ் அகர்த்தா அபோக்தா. தட் நாலேஜ் இஸ் ரிக்வயர்ட். சோ தட் டிவிஷன் இஸ் வெரி கிளியர் இன் தி வேதாஸ் இட்செல்ஃப். சோ த டிவிஷன் பேஸ்ட் ஆன் ஒன்ஸ் கன்விக்ஷன், ஒன்ஸ் அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்டிங். தெர்ஃபோர் ஞான அண்ட் கர்மா, தே கனாட் பி கம்பைன்ட் சின்ஸ் தே ஆர் மென்ஷன்ட் செப்பரேட்லி பை பகவான் அண்ட் ஆஸ் இட்ஸ் பேசிஸ் ஆஷ்ரயா இன் டிஃபரெண்ட் கன்விக்ஷன்ஸ், டிஃபரெண்ட் அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்டிங். So this this line jnana karma nishta yogo vibhaga vachanat buddhi dvayashraya yogo is a sangraha vakyam. It's a brief statement which will be elaborated by Bhagavan, Bhagavad Pada. So in the next few lines he describes what he said now. So this is how the bhashya goes. First he gives a brief statement, then he himself elaborates the statement. So he says, we will continue, we will read, we can repeat. Ashochyan ityadina,
Ashochyan ityadina
Bhagavata yavat, பரமார்த்த ஆத்மதத்வ நிரூபணம். கிருதம் தத் சாங்க்யம்,
கிருதம் தத் சாங்க்யம்
தத் விஷயா புத்திஹி,
தத் விஷயா புத்திஹி
ஆத்மனஹ,
ஆத்மனஹ
ஜன்மாதி,
ஜன்மாதி
ஷட் விக்ரிய அபாவாத்,
ஷட் விக்ரிய அபாவாத்
ஆத்மா இத் அகர்த்தா ஆத்மா இதி, பிரகரணார்த்த நிரூபணாத், யா ஜாயதே தா சாங்க்யா புத்திஹி, சாங்க்யா புத்தி சாயேஷாம்,
சாயேஷாம்
ஞானினாம்,
ஞானினாம்
உசிதா பவதி,
உசிதா பவதி
பவதி
தே சாங்க்யாஹ,
தே
சாங்க்யாஹ.
ஓகே, இது சாங்க்ய புத்தி, சாங்க்ய புத்தி, சாங்க்ய புத்தி only. Okay, we will see the meaning. So Bhagavad Pada, he used the word Sankhya. Sankhya is not one of the darshanam. Sankhya darshanam, Vaisheshika darshanam, no. We will see what Sankhya is. We will see the Vyutpatti also. So now let us take the first line. அசோச்சியான் இத்தியாதினா பகவதா யாவத் சுதர்மமபி சாவேக்ஷ்ய இதி ஏதத் அந்தேன க்ரந்தேன யத் பரமார்த்தத் யத் பரமார்த்த ஆத்மதத்துவம் நிரூபணம் கிருதம் தத் சாங்க்யம். சோ தி வேர்ட் சாங்க்யம் இஸ் எக்ஸ்பிளைன்ட் பை பகவான் ஹிம்செல்ஃப். மெனி சே பகவான் ஹியர் இன் திஸ் கான்டெக்ஸ்ட் பகவான் இஸ் பகவத் பாதா. ஓகே, சோ பகவத் பாதா ஹிம்செல்ஃப். Sankhya means Literally, it means Paramatma. Sankhyam means Paramatma. Sankhya Buddhihi means knowledge of Paramatma. Sankhya Buddhihi, knowledge of Paramatma. The conviction in the absolute self, Atma, Paramatma. It's called Sankhya Buddhihi. So starting from the shloka, Ashochyan and Vashochyastom, that is second chapter, 11th shloka, starting from that shloka up to the shloka number 31, Svadharmam Abhicha Vekshya, of the second chapter. Through these shlokas, Bhagavan has established Nirupanam. Bhagavan has established Nirupanam. He did the Nirupanam of the Paramartha Atma Tattva. The truth of the ultimate reality, Atma Paramatma. Bhagavata Kritam. Ityadina, in this Prakarana, in this topic, starting from the second chapter, 11th shloka, up to the 31st shloka, in this Prakarana, Bhagavata Kritam. Bhagavan, by Bhagavan, it is done. What is done? Kim Kritam, Bhagavata. Yatu Paramartha Atma Tattvam Nirupanam Tatu Sankhyam. The understanding which a person gets from the teaching starts from second chapter 11th shloka to the second chapter 31st shloka. The understanding which a person gets from the teaching is called Sankhya Buddhi. The understanding which a person gets is called Sankhya Buddhi. Because Sankhya is a top subject matter described in this prakarana, in this portion. So, tat vishaya buddhihi, the subject matter of that understanding, the knowledge is, what is that? The subject matter of that understanding is, atmanaha janmadishat vikriya abhavat akarta atma. Atma is akarta. Atma is the akarta, that is the buddhi, that is the understanding, that is the subject matter of this prakarana, this portion. Atmanaha janmadishat vikriya abhavat akarta. Why Atma is akarta? Because Atma doesn't have janma, marana, etc. This shat vikriya, that vikriya is change. Atma is akarta. Atma is free from doership. How? Because there is no vikriya, there is no modification in Atma. Atma doesn't have this sixfold modifications. Shat vikriya abhavat. Atma is vikriyaha because it is free from modification. What are those modifications? Asti, jayate, vardate, viparinamate, apakshiyate, vinashyati. You remember this from the Tattva Bodha. Asti. Asti is it exists. Jayate asti. First the born. Asti, the jiva is born, then asti che, then it has to exist, jiva has to survive, therefore asti. Vardate, vardate grows, viparinamate, it undergoes changes. Apakshiyate, then it slowly decays and finally vinashyati, gets destroyed. This sixfold modifications is only for the body. It's only for the body, not for the atma. Therefore, this shat vikriya, which is for the shariram, not for the Atma, therefore, abhavat, atmanaha akarta. Since Atma is free from that, because of the absence of this sixfold modifications, Atma is akarta, Atma is nirvikaraha. Nirvikaraha, Atma. There is no vikara, change in the Atma. And Atma is abhokta, Atma is nityaha. Atma is Shuddha, Atma is Sarvagataha. The understanding, this understanding of the reality of Atma is called Sankhya Buddhi. Tat Vishaya Buddhi, Sankhya Buddhi. The understanding which is born of the analysis of this Prakarana, Prakaranam, the topic, is called Sankhya Buddhi. So Sankhyam means Jnanam, Jnanam of Paramatma. And the understanding of this is called Sankhya Buddhi. The one who has this understanding, Sankhya Buddhi. Okay, who is that? Is this called Sankhya? Bhagavan, he refers to them as Sankhya, which means Jnanis. சா ஏஷாம் ஞானினாம் உச்சிதா பவதி தே சாங்க்யாஹ. சா சா இஸ் சா புத்தி, சா சாங்க்ய புத்தி. ஏஷாம் ஞானினாம் தட் புத்தி, சா புத்தி, சா சாங்க்யா புத்தி. இன் ஹூம் இட் இஸ் வெல் அசிமிலேட்டட், ஹூ ஆர் டே, தே ஆர் ஞானிஸ், தே ஆர் சாங்க்யாஸ். சோ சாங்க்யாஸ் ஆர் தோஸ் ஞானிஸ் ஹூ ஹாவ் திஸ் ஞானம் வெல் அசிமிலேட்டட். சோ சாங்க்யாஹ இயர் தே சாங்க்யாஹ, சாங்க்யாஹ இயர் ரெஃபர்ஸ் டு தி பீப்புள், தி ஜானி, ஞானினாம் ஆஃப் தோஸ் ஞானிஸ். சோ சாங்க்ய புத்தி இஸ் நாலேஜ் ஆஃப் ஆத்மா and sankhyas mean jnanis. So the word sankhya, it is a taditanta shabda, it has got a tadita pratyaya, taditanta shabda. It is derived from the verbal root kya, kya is a verbal root, sam upasarga is there. So samyak khyayate prakashyate atma tattvam anaya iti sankhya. சமயக் கியாயதே பிரகாஷ்யதே ஆத்ம தத்துவம், தட் விச் கியாயதே, விச் கிளியர்லி கிளியர்லி கிவ்ஸ், பிரகாஷ்யதே ஷைன்ஸ் தி வாட் ஆத்ம தத்துவம், தட் பை விச் தி ஆத்ம தத்துவம் இஸ் கிளியர்லி ஷைன்ஸ், கிளியர்லி இட் இஸ் ரிவீல்ட், இஸ் கால்ட் சாங்க்யா. தட் புத்தி இஸ் கால்ட் சாங்க்ய புத்தி. த ஒன் ஹூ ஹாஸ் தட் சாங்க்ய புத்தி இஸ் கால்ட் சாங்க்யாஸ் ஞானீஸ். So this statement, he described what Sankhya Buddhi is and what who Sankhyas are. Then the next line we will read. Etasyaha buddhehe.
Etasyaha buddhehe.
Janmanaha prak.
Janmanaha prak.
Atmanaha.
Atmanaha.
தேஹாதி வ்யதிரிக்தத்வ கர்த்ருத்வ போக்த்ருத்வாதி. தர்ம அதர்ம விவேக பூர்வக, மோக்ஷ சாதன அனுஷ்டான லக்ஷணஹ. யோகஹ தத் விஷயா புத்திஹ. யோக புத்திஹ சா ஏஷாம் கர்மிணாம் உச்சிதா பவதி தே யோகினஹ. ஓகே, சோ இன் திஸ் லைன்ஸ் பகவத் பாதா இ பிரசன்ஸ் ஹூ ஆர் தி யோகீஸ், யோக புத்தி அண்ட் யோகீஸ். ஹியர் த யோக புத்தி யூ ஹேவ் டு அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் what is yoga buddhi. So after sankhya buddhi, now bhagavan here he presents yoga buddhi. Before that bhagavan explains what is yoga. What is yoga? Anushtana lakshanah yogah, that is clear. Anushtana lakshanah yogah. Yoga is characterized in the form of the performance of karma. Anushtana nirupana lakshanah yogah, as what moksha sadanam anushtana lakshanah yogah. Moksha sadanam means of gaining moksha, not direct but indirect means therefore moksha sadana anushtana nirupana lakshanah yogah. That is performance of karma as an indirect means to moksha is what characterizes yoga. So yoga means what? Karma. Yoga is here in this context, it is karma. The first line, etasyaha buddhehe, etasyaha buddhehe janmanaha prak is there. What is etasyaha? After talking about Sankhya Buddhi, the next time he says etasyaha. Etasyaha is a pronoun. Therefore, it must refer to Sankhya. Therefore, it must refer to Sankhya Buddhi. So, etasyaha buddhehe. Kasyaha buddhehe? Sankhya buddhehe. Etasyaha buddhehe janmanaha prak. Janmanaha is birth, rise. Therefore, prak is before. Prak is before. So, before the rise of this buddhi, what buddhi? Sankhya buddhi. Therefore, Sankhya buddhehe janmanaha prak. Etasyaha refers to Sankhyaha. So, before the rise, before the birth of Sankhya buddhi, what buddhi was there? Yoga buddhi was there first. Before the rise of Sankhya buddhi, yoga buddhi is there. Then only Sankhya buddhi. Therefore, then only comes Sankhya buddhi. Therefore, which is the means to moksha? Yoga buddhi or Sankhya buddhi? Sankhya buddhi. So, direct means to moksha is Sankhya buddhi. And yoga buddhi, it is the indirect means to moksha. So, Sankhya buddhehe janmanaha prak, before that, what buddhi was the yoga buddhi. Therefore, yoga buddhi cannot be the direct means to moksha, it is indirect means to moksha. So, it means what? It means the Vaidika karma, the karma enjoined by the Shastram must be followed before the birth of Sankhya buddhi. Before the birth of Sankhya buddhi, the karma has to be observed. And for doing Vaidika karma, one must have the understanding. What understanding? Atmanaha dehadi vitiriktatva kartritva bhoktratvadi apekshaha. Atma is different from dehadi vitiriktatva. It is different from body, mind, sense complex. Dehadi vitirikta. Tat vitiriktatva, the status of being. Vitiriktatva, when you say the status of being different from the body, mind, sense complex, what? Atma, and also Atma as the apeksha. Apeksha as a basis on what? Karta and bhokta. Kartrutvam and bhoktrutvam is attributed to Atma, which is distinct from Dehadi, the body, mind, sense complex. Kartrutvam and Bhoktrutvam is attributed to Atma and it is Dehadi Vitirikta, different from body, mind, sense complex. Atma is considered to be Karta and Bhokta because karma is involved. For the people who does karma, they take Atma to be Karta, Bhokta. Therefore, because Kartrutvam is involved, for doing Kartrutvam, because they do karma, they want to enjoy the karma pala, therefore kartrutvam is there. And for doing karma, viveka is required. Because for karma, there is a choice. One can choose to do karma, dharma, right action, or one can choose to accomplish things by adharma, also wrong action. So choosing between dharma and adharma, it requires viveka. Any action requires viveka. And for following the karmas prescribed by the Shastram, one must have Shraddha and Viveka. And Shastram, it enjoins right action, which may not be pleasant. And Shastram prohibits wrong action, which may be pleasant. Therefore, karma is preceded by Dharma, Adharma, Viveka. Dharma, Adharma, Vivekaha, Viveka Purvakaha. Therefore, that the karma that has got the yoga has got the adjective here dharma dharma viveka purvakaha moksha sadhana anushtana lakshanaha yogaha. Therefore, the meaning of this line is the yoga, that is the pursuit of karma, which is characterized by the observance of the actions karma anushtana lakshanaha, which is the indirect means to moksha. Moksha sadhanam, indirect means, and the karma has to be observed till the rise of Sankhya buddhi. Sa etasyaha buddhehe janmanaha prak. The karma has to be observed. And the karmas are observed based on the consideration that Atma is different from body, mind, sense complex, and Atma as kartrutvam, bhoktrutvam, etc. சற்றா ஆத்மனக தேகாதி வித்திருத்தத்துவ கர்த்திருத்வ போக்திருத்வ அதி அபேக்ஷா. திஸ் இஸ் தேர்ட் பாயிண்ட். சோ ஃபோர் பாயிண்ட்ஸ் ஆர் தேர். அந்த லாஸ்ட் பாயிண்ட் இஸ் கர்மா மஸ்ட் பி ப்ரிசீடட் பை தர்ம அதர்ம விவேக விவேக பூர்வக. சோ த ஃபோர் பாயிண்ட்ஸ் பகவத் பாதா மென்ஷன்ஸ். த ஃபர்ஸ்ட் பாயிண்ட் இஸ் தட் இஸ் மோக்ஷ சாதன அனுஷ்டான லக்ஷணம், தட் இஸ் நம்பர் ஒன். அண்ட் எதஸ்யாஹ புத்தேஹ ஜென்மனஹ பிராக், பிஃபோர் த ரைஸ் ஆஃப் திஸ் சாங்கிய புத்தி, தட் இஸ் நம்பர் டூ. அண்ட் திஸ் கர்மாஸ் ஆர் அப்சர்வ்ட், திஸ் கர்மாஸ் ஆர் அப்சர்வ்ட் பேஸ்ட் ஆன் தி கன்சிடரேஷன். வாட் இஸ் தி அபேக்ஷா? தேகாதி வித்திரித்தத்வ கர்த்திருத்வ போக்திருத்வ, தட் இஸ் தி பேசிஸ். சோ ஆத்மா இஸ் டிஃபரெண்ட் ஃப்ரம் பாடி மைண்ட் சென்ஸ் காம்ப்ளெக்ஸ் அண்ட் இட் ஹேஸ் தி ஸ்டேட்டஸ் ஆஃப் பீங் கர்த்தா அண்ட் போக்தா, தட் இஸ் தி தேர்ட் பாயிண்ட். And this karma is preceded by the knowledge, by the discriminative knowledge of dharma and adharma. Dharma, adharma, viveka purvakaha iti. So the yoga is described by Bhagavad Pada by these four adjectives. Yoga, what is yoga is described. And this pursuit of karma, which is characterized by these four points, what I mentioned, is called yoga. It's called yoga. And tad vishaya buddhihi, yoga buddhihi. Tad vishaya buddhihi, yoga buddhihi. The subject matter of that understanding, that conviction, that knowledge is called yoga buddhi. Understanding the nature of the pursuit of karma is called yoga buddhi. சா ஏஷாம் கர்மிணாம் உச்சிதா பவதி தே யோகினஹ. சா, வாட் இஸ் சா? யோக புத்தி. யோக புத்தி, சா யோக புத்தி, விச் இஸ் உச்சிதா, விச் இஸ் அப்ராப்ரியேட், விச் இஸ் அப்ராப்ரியேட், விச் இஸ் வெல் அசிமிலேட்டட் இன் ஹூம் தே ஆர் கால்ட் யோகினஹ. சோ யோகிஸ் ஆர் தோஸ் ஃபார் ஹூம் திஸ் யோக புத்தி, திஸ் யோக புத்தி இஸ் ப்ராப்பர். சா ஏஷாம் கர்மினாம் உச்சிதா பவதி, திஸ் யோக புத்தி இஸ் ப்ராப்பர், இஸ் அப்ராப்ரியேட் இன் ஹூம் தே ஆர் கால்ட் யோகீஸ். தேர்ஃபோர் பகவான் ஹஸ் கிளியர்லி மென்ஷன் இன் தி கீதா இட்ஸெல்ஃப், ஞான யோகேன சாங்கியானாம் கர்மயோகேன யோகினாம், தட் டிவிஷன் இஸ் பிகாஸ் ஆஃப் திஸ் டூ டிஃபரெண்ட் அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்டிங்ஸ், டூ டிஃபரெண்ட் கன்விக்ஷன்ஸ், நாலேஜ். ஒன் இஸ் சாங்கிய புத்தி, அதர் ஒன் இஸ் யோக புத்தி. தேர்ஃபோர் the divisions, the distinction is very clear. Therefore jnana and karma, they are distinct, they are separate. Karma is can play an indirect role in gaining moksha, it cannot play a direct role because of the very lifestyle, because of the distinction presented by the Bhagavan, and also the distinction is clearly shown in the Veda itself. Veda itself gives two options, not options. Veda itself gives Veda Purva and Vedanta. So there is not a choice involved, choosing the Veda Purva or Vedanta. There is no choice. It is after Veda Purva, Vedanta. The person has to grow from Veda Purva to Vedanta. That is karma is followed karma followed by jnanam. First karma. Through karma, you get chitta shuddhi, you become qualified, you get the jnana yogyata, the capacity to gain the jnanam. That preparation happens in the Veda Purva, the karma kanda, where the conviction is atma is karta, atma is bhokta. That is why the karma is done. Karma is done to enjoy the karma palam in the other loka. Therefore, that kartrutvam and bhoktrutvam is attributed to Atma. And after Veda Purva, after gaining certain maturity, through the accomplishment of Dharmartha Kama Purusharta, the person grows into a Mokshartha. He understands that the Trivida Purusharta is not enough, it's not helpful in gaining what he wants. What he wants is freedom. Therefore, goes to moksha, that is Vedanta, and there he get there it comes to know that jnanena mokshaha, therefore from there is a transition happens from yoga buddhi to sankhya buddhi. Therefore it is a growing, it's a growth, it's a growing clarity. So karma first and then jnana, and through jnana the person gets moksha. Therefore the clear distinction is there. So no samuchaya is possible. So no samuchaya, we cannot synthesize the karma and the jnana, both has to go hand in hand to gain moksha is not acceptable. So that is clearly presented by the statement jnana karma nishta yogo vibhaga vachanat. That vibhaga vachana, vibhaga is division, vachana, because of the vachana, the same, because of the words of the Bhagavan, that the division is clearly is mentioned. Why? Because buddhi dvaya, two types of buddhis are there, which has its basis in jnana nishta and karma nishta, that is sankhya buddhi and yoga buddhi. And therefore there are two sets of people, sankhya and yogis, and they have got different lifestyles. So this is clearly presented by the Bhagavad Pada as the answer to the Purva Pakshi. Who is a Purva Pakshi? That Jnana Karma Samuchaya Vadi. And further Bhagavan, Bhagavad Pada, he continues. We'll see in the next class. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om. Thank you.
Thank you.